been instrumental in the past to facilitate a deeper understanding of the relationship between ecological systems and human institutions, or as some of you call it, social ecological systems. Since long, it organizes, structures, really scholarly agendas and also research sharing, but at the same time it links up with practitioners, so they are really informed by our approaches and we get nice information, feedback from them. And we work together with people structuring policy processes, which is also very nice interaction, and this is what makes the ISC so unique, because we do not only gather scientists from various disciplines, but the three groups, including practitioners and policy makers, as we call them in short. The ISCP has been founded in 1990, at that time by Elinor Ostrom. I'm sure most of you know her at least as having won the Nobel Prize in 2009, but may have studied quite some of her work related to the various aspects you work in. You could summarize it also that way, but one of its functions is to also prove that this original and quite wide known article of Garrett Hardin, wrongly titled Tragedy of the Commons and predicting that all shared resources will degrade in the future if we not privatize them, or call in the help of the government. So therefore we brought together a massive array of evidence all over the world that communities are able to manage their common resources quite successfully. In 2006 we changed our name, so we basically dropped the P and came up with International Association for the Study of the Commons. From there we widened our perspective also to the new commons, yeah, and this is where your White Seats project came in. Also looking on housing issues, health issues, yeah, school issues, information knowledge, everything you would put under the new commons title. Also global commons, biodiversity, deep sea climate change turns out to be quite an issue recently. And because our scholars managed to have this huge amount of case studies and meta studies from all the individual information, we could more and more work on methods, concepts, theories, and frameworks to really find the determinants we need to work on governance structures, successful ones for the future. First of all, is of course our open access flagship journal, the International Journal of the Commons, which is only 10 years old, has already an easy citation index, and you may maybe not so much aware of this figure here, so around 1,000 sociology and political science journals, it's in the top 10. So be aware and consider it for publication in the future if you like to. We also run the Elinor Ostrom Award. We are not sponsoring it. Yeah, this is very important. So we are not the ones giving the money to the prize winner, but we organize it, we set up the nomination committee and the evaluation process. And if you are a member of the ISC, you can currently nominate persons for the three categories of the prize. We also made 2 years ago a survey and put up all the teaching material we could find on the commons on the website. So that could be something for you to search if you like to find something for teaching or for having an easy access to some kind of matter. We also relaunched our website and made it quite decentralized. That's why we also came up with the structure of the regional groups. And therefore it offers much more room for regional local activity, like your workshop here today, which we can run under our umbrella. Besides these social media activities, we finally started off with various task force. We will also have a first virtual conference this November, which we want to try out, that people don't need to travel. Then we will have a video contest. So up until November, you can submit a 3-minute video on the comments, of course, and on your topic. And if you win, you are able to receive $3,000 from a fund we brought in. And which brings me back to this story of Gerrit Hahn he once put up. If you remember the time he published, that's exactly 50 years ago. That's why we took this year of coming up with the International Commons Awareness Week. So during this week in October, we will host, run, and organize various little events around the globe to show to the audience, to the public, and basically also a lot to the press and everybody that the Commons brought up such a lively and massive amount of research where we can draw from. So if you would click on this website, I mean, we actually did it, we made it from scratch, and now we need to fill this big event. So we will have an introductory policy seminar and conference in Washington, and then if you would go on globally distributed local events, you end up here with all the flags. So, and please introduce your flag.